Cigarettes emit between 40,000 and 100,000 different chemicals when they're actively smoked. And there's lots of research demonstrating the breadth of different types of chemicals that we're being exposed to via mainstream or environmental tobacco smoke. There's a lot less research on what happens once the cigarette's been put out. And so we wanted to look at what were the types of different conditions that a cigarette butt might be exposed to, and how might that affect the emissions. To do that, we created our own machine where we replicated the smoking process. We were interested in seeing how the airborne emissions would change when they were exposed to different environmental conditions. So look at temperature, relative humidity, water saturation, UV intensity, and air change rate to figure out how the emission might change if it was put into those environments. The biggest surprise was that the amount of chemical that you could be potentially exposed to from a cigarette butt is not insignificant. Could be 20% of the chemical that you're exposed to if somebody was smoking nearby you. If the smoker is smoking indoors, you have exposure to the secondhand smoke while they're actively smoking. You have exposure to the third-hand smoke, which is chemicals sticking to your furniture, your carpet, your walls, and then coming back off later. And then you have what we are now calling after smoke, which would be the smoke that's coming off of the cigarette butt. It's going to slowly decrease, but it's never going to go to zero. To avoid your exposure to these chemicals, seal your butts. Put your butts in some kind of sealed container after you smoke so that you're not exposing others to this source of after smoke.